Welcome to college.
Pop up hamper.
Shower caddy.
Hot plate.
Beanbag chair.
Hilarious shirt that signals we drink alcohol. Three shower poofs.
Some bacon machine that my mom got me. I do not understand how it works.
This thing.
Q-tips.
Beanbag chair. Comfort that I will not wash for the next 6 months.
It's true.
It's Lottie. Welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be a what to bring to college video. I wanted to talk a little bit today about what I think are some of the absolute essentials. Obviously, this isn't everything, but these are a few like cliche college items that you hear that I actually do think are worth the hype. On Friday, I'm gonna have a video coming about what not to bring to college. So stay tuned for that because a lot of you asked me like, what should I bring? What should I not bring? I thought I would do a little two-part series today and Friday. So that video will be next. And once it's up, I'll go back and link it in the description. I'm super excited about this video today because I have 2 years of college under my belt. If you're new here, I just finished my sophomore year at the University of Georgia. So I lived in the dorm my freshman year and I lived in my sorority house my sophomore year. But the sorority house is basically like a dorm too. I really have 2 years of like dorm life under my belt. I'm actually getting to live in an apartment next year. So I'll have my own bathroom. Give this video a thumbs up if you love college videos. I think they're so fun. I watched so many before I went to college. So, and subscribe if you're new because I put up new videos every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, and I would absolutely love to have you. So let's go ahead and get started. Okay, the first thing that you need to bring to college is a portable phone charger. I got one of these the first week I went to college. At the time, my phone would die really fast, but even if your phone has like a good battery life, I would still get one of these and bring it with you. I always have it with me at college, and especially if you have like a really long day or something. It's also great for college game days, and that'll be really helpful because game days are like obviously really long. You start tailgating really early, you know, with the game and everything. You like want to use your phone all the time to like be texting your friends, like figuring out where they're sitting, Snapchatting and Instagramming the game, and I don't know, definitely an essential for game days as well. Any kind of longer day like that, you'll want to have that with you. So if you don't already have one of those, I would definitely get one. They are really nice to have. Next thing that I think you should bring to college are the flat hangers. I just have the velvet flat thin hangers. They've been amazing. The velvet hangers are wonderful because your clothes then don't fall off of them, and because they're so thin, you can fit so much more. In dorms, you have a really small amount of closet space, so you have to be able to fit everything you can in there, and the flat hangers really help with that. I just love how it all looks the same. I have a lot of like off the shoulder like tank tops, and those just like don't hang well on like those plastic hangers. For girls especially, I think that that's something you should totally get. The next one's kind of underrated, but get lots of underwear. Before I went to college, I got like 20 new pairs of underwear. You'll get your use out of them, I promise. Honestly, you can't have too much underwear. It was the best thing ever because I didn't have to do laundry for like a month. I think it's something that people might forget about, but is definitely an essential. I really didn't have to do laundry that often because I had so many pairs of underwear, so. It's just like a little pro tip. I'm like lazy organized, so like I think about like, okay, I'm gonna get a bunch of underwear so I don't have to do laundry, and I'm gonna get a laundry bin big enough to where it's not overflowing after 3 weeks. Just a good move, can't go wrong. Next thing I have is like string lights and lamps. A lot of people just get these for like decor reasons, but my reason for getting this is a little bit different. Not only are they cute and yeah, decor and whatever, but I think that they're awesome because then you can turn off your overhead lights and just turn on your string lights and your lamps, and that's the perfect setup for like if you're roommate is wanting to go to bed and you're needing to stay up and do work or study or vice versa. It's a really good low light but enough light kind of situation to where you can like still be doing work or go to bed. Sometimes when I was having a really busy week, I would need to stay up another hour and do some more homework, but my roommate was ready to go to bed, so it was really nice that we had lamps and stuff so I could just like keep a lamp or two on while I was finishing that up and she could still like roll over and go to bed without it being super bright. Not only are they cute, but it really helps out in situations like that. Next is power strips. You're gonna want so many power strips. As a girl in 2018, I have so many things I have to charge, okay? My camera, my headphones, my Fitbit, my phone, my laptop, my hair curler, my hair dryer, my hair straightener, makeup mirror, my TV, my Apple TV. So you get the picture. There's a lot to plug in. You're gonna want power strips. So I had, I think, 2 or 3 in my room this past year, but honestly, you can't have too many. I would at least bring 2. That's a literal essential and No joke, you can't forget that. All right, next is for the shower, and I actually have a whole video about like all about the dorm bathrooms, like how to survive them. So I'll put that in a link down below and leave it in a card. In that video, I talk a little bit more about the dorm bathroom, but I'm just gonna quickly say that the things that I found useful for dorm bathrooms were having a towel wrap, so just like a Velcro one, really great for going down the hall just to have something to cover you up so you're not like holding your towel, it like holds itself there. Love those, use those for the past 2 years. Shower shoes, major key, you guys. Shower shoes are so important. So I just used like some Adidas slides because I didn't want to have to buy new cheap Old Navy flip-flops every month when they break. So I just got something sturdy that would last me. I know like a lot of people just get like Walmart flip-flops and then just like replace them when they break, but shower shoes, so important. You don't want to get like foot funguses. You don't know who, especially like on the hall bathrooms. If you have a suite bathroom, but I would still use it, but especially if you are using like a community hall style bathroom. You don't want to forget those. And then the last thing, obviously, for the shower that you will definitely need is a shower caddy. Another thing you definitely will want is a mattress topper. The mattresses that come in most dorm rooms are literal bricks. That's a no-go for me. I love my mattress topper. It literally takes your bed from 0 to 100 real quick. So it's basically just like a 2 to 5 inch like memory foam that you just put on top of your brick mattress, and then you zip that up in your like mattress protector, which is another important thing to remember to bring. Definitely makes your bed really comfy. You'll never want to get out of your bed once you get one, so it's amazing. Love those, definitely get one. Next thing is a little random, but it's a Steripod. If you don't know what those are, or just like a toothbrush cover, it doesn't have to be a Steripod. Steripods are great. They have them at Bed Bath & Beyond, Target, Walmart. So all you do is clip the Steripod on the head of your toothbrush. It just keeps your toothbrush clean and kind of like filters out some of those germs, especially if you're like keeping your toothbrush in your shower caddy. You don't have your own bathroom anymore, you're like having to bring your toothbrush all around, so I would just recommend getting that because it's really helpful, especially like when you're packing to go home too and like bringing your toothbrush. It's nice to have that cover on there. I love my Steripod. Definitely get one of those. I think they're a great thing to have. Next thing you definitely want to bring is a makeup mirror. So especially if you have a community style bathroom, you will want to get ready in your own room. If you are used to getting ready in the bathroom and you don't already have a makeup mirror, you'll definitely want to get one of those. I just would keep it on my desk and you know, you can have your makeup bag there and then just get ready in your room. My favorite is from Simple Human. It is wireless. You do have to charge it, but it's wireless. You only have to charge it like maybe once a week. It's just like, you can see every pore. My mirror was definitely expensive, but I love it and it's lasted me really well. So any makeup mirror, definitely something that you'll want to have with you. Next thing is kind of optional, but I just wanted to bring it to your attention if you hadn't thought about it, and that's an ottoman. So I had an ottoman in my dorm room freshman year and sophomore year, different ottoman but same concept. So it was just like a circle ottoman with a lid. If you've seen either of my dorm tours, which I'll link both of those down below as well, so I have my ottoman in both of those if you want to see like how I used it. But I loved my ottoman. I put my shoes in it and it was really great to have that extra seating, not only for guests but like for myself. I would sit on it while I was putting my shoes on. It's a great place to put your shoes, I'm not gonna lie. I think that it's the best kind of way to do shoe storage. My closet just doesn't have a ton of room, and my closet freshman year like really didn't have a door, it was a curtain. So having that ottoman was awesome for that, and it was just really great to have this extra seating. I got mine at Home Goods both years. Obviously that's not totally necessary, but I did think that it was really nice to have both years if you can fit one in your room. So just something to think about. Another thing you're definitely gonna wanna grab are some drawer liners. I think this is a great thing to get. When I move in, I always wipe down the drawers and then put some drawer liners in there. It makes it feel a lot cleaner and fresher and just helps you feel more organized. All right, next thing is a total cliche and you probably already know, but command hooks. I can't say enough good things about them. I won't spend too long talking about them, but you'll definitely want command hooks. Most places you can't damage the walls, so command strips are perfect for hanging up posters, pictures, any kind of decor. You'll definitely want to get some of those. Another thing I got a lot of use out of was my boyfriend pillow. I had one of these along with a lot of my friends and we all loved them. Every day I would make my bed. My boyfriend pillow was great because my bed was up against the wall and it just made it more of like a day bed. So I would like sit on my made bed and like have my boyfriend pillow between me and the wall. I hope this makes sense. Like when I was just doing work on my computer or something, a boyfriend pillow is definitely a great thing to have. I got a lot of use out of mine. Another thing that I think would be good to bring, I actually never had But I think it's a really great idea, and that's a lap desk, especially if you have a small space. Just an idea, I think it would have been useful to have that. All right, we're getting down to the last few things. Another one that you'll definitely want to bring is a cordless hand vacuum. My roommate Jenna brought a cordless hand vac freshman year, and we got so much use out of it, especially as opposed to like a full-size vacuum. You just charge it up and then you can take it all around your room and just like vacuum up any little like crumbs from food. Girls shed hair so much, so just like getting hair up is a lot of it. If your rug is shedding at all, just getting that up. It's just nice. It makes your room feel a lot cleaner. So that was definitely a great thing that my roommate brought. And the last thing I could think of for this video that would be a great thing to bring would be a steamer. This would be as opposed to like an ironing board. Obviously, like that would take up so much space. So a steamer is perfect. It's so tiny. You can just like put it in a cubby somewhere and pull it out when you need it. You just like steam out your clothes to get any wrinkles out. Having a really crammed closet space can definitely wrinkle up some of your clothes unintentionally. So I actually don't have a steamer, but my friend Rachel does, and I borrow hers, and I feel bad. I really do need to get my own. If you've like never ironed or steamed or like pressed any of your stuff at home before, you probably won't use a steamer. So you just have to think about yourself and your habits with all of these things. But for me, like, I don't really want to go out in a shirt that's super wrinkled. And it's really nice to have a steamer so that you don't have to and you can wear what you want. And also, you can definitely share your steamer between you and your roommate, so you only need to get one between the two of you. Same with the hand vacuum, so just like split it up between your roommate and figure out who's gonna bring what. So that's gonna be it for my what I think you should bring to college video. Give it a thumbs up if it was helpful and maybe I shared something with you hadn't thought of. Comment down below if you have any other college essentials that I didn't mention, because this is by no means an exhaustive list. This is just a few things that I think are really major key to bring. And also let me know what other videos you want to see. I'm always taking video requests and I just want to make videos that you all want to watch. So subscribe if you're new and you enjoyed this video. I would love to have you. And I will have my what not to bring to college video coming on Friday. So definitely stay tuned for that. I think that's going to be it for today. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye everyone.